I love reading stories. You know, I read this book when I was maybe 7 years old about a tiny girl who used to live amongst flowers. And my dream was to grow up and live in a flower too. I was always curious about how her house might have looked like. Well, today's our chance. I have some hibiscus flowers with me here. So beautiful. But we will have to cut this open to observe what's inside the flower. Let us cut open the hibiscus flower and figure out the parts. Let me lay its parts on the table. Let's look at the parts of this flower closely. This leaf-like part on the outside are called sepals. This colorful part here is the petal. It is usually the most prominent part of the flower. Inside the petals are stamen and pistils. How can we distinguish between the two? Often, stamens are more in number as compared to pistils. But that's not always the case. If you look at the stamen, it has two parts. The filament and the anther. The anther often has dust-like material on it. That's the pollen. The pistil, on the other hand, has three parts. The one at the bottom, the ovary. The style, which is like the neck. And the stigma, which is the slightly sticky part on the top. Flowers are so simple, yet so complex. Let's see what is on the inside of the ovary of a hibiscus flower. Do you see these bead-like structures? They are called ovules. Fascinating, isn't it? Let's go have a look at what is inside the anther. Anther is the pollen factory. Once they are made, anther burst and pollen are on the top of the anther. Let me get out of here quickly.
Now that we have looked at the flower in various ways, I have to ask you, have you seen a plant that has no flowers? Yes, there are several plants like moss, fern, pine that do not have flowers. So, not all plants have flowers.
The ones that do they all have 5 petals like the hibiscus flowers? No. If you look at different flowers carefully, you will realize that different flowers have different colors, number of petals, different number of sepals, different attachments with stamen and pistils. What do you think happens to these flowers? This is one of my favorite flowers. It has fleshy petals. It has so many stamens and so many pistils. It almost always has honeybees visiting it. It makes a sweet nectar for bees and other insects. After some time, the petals fall and a big brown fruit emerges. And when it falls, it makes a loud noise. That also gives the name to the tree, the cannonball tree. Let's do a quick recap of the parts of flowers. This is the outermost sepal, the prominent petal, the stamen, and the pistil. The stamen has a filament and the anther. The pistil has the stigma, the style, and the ovary. I cannot imagine how that little girl lived among flowers. She must have constantly been disturbed by ants, bees, and the pollen. Ha! It is a fairy tale. It may not be possible to live inside flowers, but it is certainly possible to live around them. Let me water my plants. Next time you walk around flowering plants, try to observe them carefully. And remember, we stay curious.